Hey there, I'm Michael Torpy. I'm an actor and a comedian. You may know me from working on Orange is the New Black. I'm also the creator and host of Paid Off, the game show that's exposing the student debt bullshit. I hope I do honor to Bob Ross. I loved his show growing up, and it would always feel like magic. I'm not much of a visual artist. I can't do it. What you've brought me here to do today, I cannot do. So we'll see what happens. Sunset aglow. This is a 2-inch, boom, sap green. Nuts! Oh no, he's doing yellow ochre. That's not right. Bang, 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 and then we'll get a little bit of a taste of this down in the bottom here. This sunset's already aglow. This is a blast. He jumped over into the red so fast. Oh, that's closer. Oh man, he's so fast. That feels very poorly blended there. Oh man, once you start screwing up a painting, you just screwed up more. Oh my God. It goes off the rail so fast.
It's a big old cloud. It's just sitting right up here in the sky.
Oh, how does he just have it all nice and white and fluffy? Like everything I touch just turns to blue. This started off so relaxing, and I think I got excited. I did so much work to set the expectations low, and then I let them get up. If I expect failure and I fail, then I look like I knew what I was talking about. But if I expect failure and I succeed, it's like, where'd that come from? Oh man, I'm so out of my sorts. I've lost Bob. Oh! He's gonna just show us a squirrel pic, is that what he's saying? Hell yeah, he did! Bob just cut to a squirrel pic! It's not that big. I mean, he's built it up as the biggest squirrel he's ever saw, and he's like, it's as big as a small cat. What a mess. He went into the mountains. Here we go, buddy. How did he get this one way in the background there? Where'd that one come from? Ooh, footy hills. How did he get those footy hills in there? Always with the tree. He can't help himself. Like, that's a perfect painting, Bob. Don't put a tree in it. Yeah, you see that fan brush, you know he's going pine. Yeah. Come on, Bob, don't do pine. Everyone's like, you know what I loved about that sunset? The tree that blocked it. Oh my God, I look away for a second, he puts two more trees up. This guy's a tree maniac. You know what, I'm not mad about those trees. If I could block all of my emotional issues with big old trees, what a blessing. Hey, I know you didn't get the emotional support you needed as a child, but maybe put a tree on it. I can tell that he's like wrapping up by his tone, so I'm just firing paint on the just throwing up as much paint as possible.
The old clock on the wall tells me it's about time to finish this.
No, you got a minute, Bob, you got a minute, Bob. Beep, boop, beep, boop, 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 boop. Beep, boop, 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 boop. Right out of the gate, I had the colors wrong. You know, in retrospect, I do know that blue and red make purple, but in the moment, I didn't. You know, it was all building around the sunset aglow, as in the title. The mountains was a real exciting moment for me. I remember watching Bob carve those mountains in with a knife and then putting the snow on top. And then, where we knew we were headed all along, too many trees. The trees helped a lot because, again, poor blending from start to finish. So by just chunking a bunch of trees, just it covered some problem areas for the painting. Maybe that happy little squirrel that Bob showed us lives in one of these trees. And then I forgot how to spell my name. Bob Ross is a boss.